What is truth? Those words of Pontius Pilate in response to Jesus, where he says, I came to speak the truth, and those who follow me listen to the truth. Pilate says, what is truth? I think that's a question that many times we don't reflect on enough in the 21st century. We don't reflect on what truly is real. We have what some people say is truth and what other groups say is truth. But what is really real? Well, the reality, my brothers and sisters, is that we are sinners in need of a Savior. Many times we are so focused on our sins that all we can see in the world is the sin of others. Because we focus so much on our sinfulness. And yes, it is true that we are all sinners. But that is not all that we are. For first and foremost, we are children of God, created in His image and in His likeness, not defined by our sins, by the ways that we turn away from the Lord, but many times that's how we define ourselves. That's how we define the problems in humanity. Us, them. We divide ourselves against our Creator, and then we think we are in the right. It is so sad when we look at society and see that it's almost as if God does not have a place anymore. And it's not that God doesn't have a place anymore, it's that we have usurped His place. We have made idols of our sins. We raise them to being deities because we were afraid. We're afraid of what it means for us to truly give control of our lives to anyone but ourselves. We're afraid of how we can live life absent from sin, for sin is all we know, it would seem, at times. But that is not true. For you are not your sin. That is not what defines you. So I ask you, what is truth? As Christians, it'd be easy to say, well, the Word of God, of course. When was the last time we spent time with the Word of God, though? To find the truth. Christ tells His disciples, where I'm going, you will follow. They say, how can we follow, for we know not the way? What does He say? I am the way, the truth, and the life. Whoever believes in me, even though he sins, will not die, but will have everlasting life welling up within them. What is truth? For many of us, we struggle with being people of faith because our prayers aren't always answered how we want them to be answered, where they want to be answered, when we want them to be answered. And so the natural response, seemingly, would be, well, obviously God isn't paying attention to me. Obviously God then has abandoned me. But is that true? Of course not. For we look to the truth to speak to us. And what does Christ say? I will never abandon you. I will leave the Holy Spirit as advocate and guide. And yet many times, when things don't go how we want them to go, we begin to question He who is truth. Lord, if you really do love me, you'll give me what I want. Lord, if you really do love the world, you'll come back sooner rather than later. Now, I don't disagree with that one completely. But yet, we go as far as to say as well, if God is all-knowing and all-loving, would he really allow bad things to happen to good people? That is the crux, many times, of our struggle of faith. It's not a struggle with truth. It's the struggle with sin. For sin hides from us the reality of the truth of the love of God. It's easy to pass the blame. It's easy to pass the buck. It's easy to say, Lord, why didn't you intervene? To which he reminds us, why didn't you intervene? You were my hands. You were my feet. You are my disciples. You know the truth. And yet, you allowed fear and sin to dictate the actions that I didn't will, but he allows. Because our God is a loving God, he allows us to sin. Because God is a loving God, he allows us to be evil. Seems a little oxymoronical. But because he loves us, he gives us the freedom of choice. He's not a dictator that says, you must choose this way, or you must choose that way, for that isn't freedom, that isn't love. And he shows us the way. How do we serve one another? It's easy for us to serve at times those in need. We call it in Oklahoma the Oklahoma spirit. Tornadoes happen, everybody comes out. Tragedy happens, everybody comes together. But why is it that it takes a tragedy sometimes to wake us up? What is truth? The truth is, sometimes we have to be woken up, either because of our fear, our doubt, our inability to believe, our laziness, our hardness of heart and hardness of mind. We don't like to be told what to do, even by God. And yet, he loved us to the end. Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. How many times do we use that as a passing comment in life? Oh, forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. Or an Oklahoman, bless their heart. But many times, people know what they're doing. They know well what they're doing. We know well what we're doing. We aren't listening to the voice of truth. We're listening to our experience, to our truth. And making our small t truth into a capital T truth. You know, one of the difficult things about liturgy sometimes as a priest is it's all written down for me what to do in the book. There's an old saying, say the black, do the red. Some of you even may have noticed at some point early in Mass, I took the book down to look at it because I forgot what was said in the red. But that's the beauty of the liturgy. It's not about me. It's about what God has given to us and how we best emulate his example. Take, eat, take, drink. Do this in memory of me. Behold your mother. Behold your son. I thirst. It is finished. Our work isn't finished, though. We know the rest of the story. We know that Christ rises on the third day. But do we live as if that is reality? Do we live that truth? Or do we allow secular society to even invade our lives of faith? Sometimes we do. Easter egg hunts on Easter. We allow secularized society into our world. What is truth? It means standing up for righteousness and goodness and holiness, not for what I like. Because what I like doesn't matter if it is contrary to the will of the Father. That's the reality and the realization that Christ came to in the Garden of Gethsemane. In today's gospel, when Jesus says to Paul, "Put your sword in your scabbard, am I not to drink the cup that the Father has given to me?" That's what he's referencing. It's not about what we want, it's about what is needed in life. What does Christ tell us, and not just tell us, but show us about love? There's no greater love than what? To lay down your life for a friend. It's important when we see the totality of Scripture. Because what does Christ say to the apostles? He says, "I no longer call you my servants, I call you my friends." It all links together. So what, my brothers and sisters, is truth if not the Word of God?